Well, Tom and Tiffany, Paula and Rick Coleman decided to go on a trip and leave their dog in a kennel for the first time ever. But just after one day away, they got a dreaded phone call. Their beloved dog, Bo, had escaped through a gate and was gone. In the back seat of his owner's car, with his head out the window, Bo Coleman returns back to Country Brook Kennels. It is here that his owners left him so they could celebrate their 10th wedding anniversary. But they would learn the canine wanted to ring in nuptials as well.
June 5th at 7 a.m.
The kennel's owner will never forget the day. One of Country Brook's customers ignores this very specific sign telling people to keep the gate closed, and 7-year-old Bo bolts right out.
It was horrible. You have no idea how upset we were. I get tears because that's how upset I was.
The dog took off on busy Route 11 in Rochester and couldn't be caught. His owners cut their trip short to come home and look for Bo. They searched the woods, put up 1,000 lost dog signs, even created a Craigslist posting about him. And during the span of 3 weeks, they got tip after tip of sightings. They even checked out a bear standoff in Rochester in their hunt.
The bear was up the tree, but I still had to look anyways to make sure it wasn't my dog.
17 days went by when the kennel's owner, who was bartending at a wedding, found out someone had crashed the reception. O'Shea went to look for herself.
Disbelief and relief and in absolute shock.
The party pup was Bo.
I got a call first from the police saying that we have your dog. He's at the governor's inn. I said, is he in custody?
When the Colemans arrived, Bo was posing with the bride and groom.
My heart just melted. I grabbed him, hugged him, cried.
So while every wedding is special, there's no bones about it. This one was doggone great. And Bo is no worse for the wear. He lost 20 pounds, had some ticks, scrapes to his paws, and is tired but healthy. Meantime, the kennel is replacing its gates and says this is the first escape in 12 years of business. Kimberly Bookman, WMUR News 9.